Have you heard of Univer Video, your platform for Christian content? With Univer Video, it's like this. You simply subscribe and you'll have full access to our Christian content from around the world, including the UK and in English. Our main English church services are available for live streaming. On Wednesday evenings and Sunday mornings, you can revisit the Sunday morning services anytime and anywhere through Univer Video. There is also the chance to watch our live transmissions, which take place every single day from the Temple of Solomon. There are some meetings that provide simultaneous translation to English. New to Univer Video are the live pastors' meetings in English with Bishop Macedo every Thursday. If you miss it, you can catch up at any time and from anywhere. If you think that's all, how about watching transmissions from over 9 countries and in 6 different languages? All this Christian content is exclusively for you and your family right here on Univer Video. All you have to do is sign up. Already excited to get on board? Well, we have some exciting news for you. For the first 2,000 subscriptions, there is a promotional price of 50% off the annual cost. This means that you get to make a one-off payment of £32.50 for the year and get all this content with no hassle of monthly payments. So, what are you waiting for? Subscribe now. Simply go to univervideo.com online or download the application on your mobile device and complete the simple registration form. Have your bank card at the ready and simply choose your terms of payment. Before you know it, you'll be up and running. Subscribe today and discover the best Christian content online. Univer Video, a universe of Christian content within your reach.
Be inspired on Liberty Radio.
Hello and welcome to Be Inspired. Today's Tuesday Healing Day. Get ready. We're going to be using our faith in a few moments. Prepare your water. Is your water there? I have mine here. And don't forget, you who have a family member who is sick, you can use your faith on behalf of your family member. You're going to see we have a very, very strong testimony of a brother who used his faith for his brothers. Yes, he determined that as he drank the water, God was going to manifest his power in his family. And so God did. And guess what? He did it with us here on Be Inspired. This is it. So you who have just connected, if you have a pain in your body, you who have a disease, I don't know what you heard. I don't know what is happening. Maybe you received a bad news or it's a family member who has been admitted to hospital. Let's use our faith. Let's determine your healing and the healing of your family members. And get ready because you are going to be the next testimony. By the way, right now as we use our faith, the new testimonies will be born. Yes, people who are going to record their testimonies and they're going to send it here so we may play their testimonies here. And by the way, have you got testimonies? Huh? Have you experienced God's power? Have you seen results, especially you who have been healed, you who have been joining our radio programs, the TV programs, you have been joining the services, you who are using your faith with us here, you who saw results, please record a 2 minutes testimony, two minutes, talk about the before and after, and send it to this email address. Have a look there. mytestimony@uckg.org. And also via WhatsApp, 020-7686-6000. And you will be part of the great cloud. Look at that. Look at those photos there. Look at that. Yours is going to be there. Look, there is a space waiting for you there. that soon, your testimony will be played here. Soon. And I say soon because in few moments, we're going to make it happen. Do you have this faith? Huh? Do you believe that you're going to be the next testimony? I believe, and you who are agreeing there with me, I'm sure that God is going to honor our faith. So let's watch testimonies now quickly. Run there, get the water if you didn't prepare it yet. Invite your friends, repost everything we posted online. Let them know that being inspired has just begun. Let's watch the first one.
Hi, my name is Andrea. I'm from the Branch of the Cells. And before I came to the UCKG, I was suffering from leg length dyspraxia. So it stopped me from doing a lot of things in school, like participating in PE. My leg would swell up and I would start limping. So I couldn't do most of the activities that everybody else could do. And it stopped me from even going places. I'd have to stay at home. And when I started coming to the UCKG and started attending Tuesday services for healing, I started using my faith because I saw everybody else getting healed. And I was like, it can happen to me as well. And one day I just found out that I was able to walk. I didn't even notice that the healing took place. I just started walking normally. I saw that I wasn't limping and also saw that there was no swelling on my legs. So I saw my healing, and because I determined it, it became possible. And I realized that nothing is impossible when it comes to God.
That's great, Andrea. Great is your faith. Look at that. You believed, and now this problem that was affecting your leg is gone. And greater things are going to happen. May God bless you all from Los Elos, from the Midlands as well. And I determined that more testimonies will happen. Yes, no matter where you are connecting from, as I said before, you may be outside London, you may be outside England, you may be outside the United Kingdom. As we know, some of you are watching us right now from Asia, Oceania, from Africa, North, South America. Yes, and I'm going to show you now a map here for you to see where people are connecting from. Have a look there. As you can see there, what is in blue is where people connected from. Can you imagine? Look at that. We have people connecting from all over the world there. Look at that. South America, North America, nearly the whole African continent there was covered in blue there. Yes, as you can see there, the United Kingdom, Ireland there, Asia, Oceania there. Look at that. All over Europe. Down below there on the far right, New Zealand there, that last island on your left. So everywhere that is covered in blue, that's where liberty is arriving, literally. Yeah? Liberty Radio is arriving there. Look at that. People are joining our programs. They are going to our website. They are receiving life, freedom indeed. And look how great. That's because of your help. You are sponsoring this work. You are meeting the needs of God's house, so we are being able to rescue souls from everywhere, even countries where we don't have church. Did you know that? People connected there from Thailand. Yes, we don't have church there yet. People connected there from Kazakhstan, isn't it? Look at this. They're connecting from East Europe, you know, some countries we do have church. Afterwards, you can go to uckg.org. And you're going to find out more addresses there from, you know, from outside. Have a look there. People from Sri Lanka. 10 people from Sri Lanka. Look how nice. 145 from Germany. Yes. What is that one? Zekia. Zekia, yeah. 30 people there. Oman. Look at this. 3 people joined there. Thailand, as I was saying there, look at that. 7 people joined from Bangladesh as well. Yes, we are reaching out to people there. South Korea. Uzbekistan. Can you imagine? 4 people there. Armenia as well. See, there is one soul there. This is it. Azerbaijan. Azerbaijan, yes. How many people Azerbaijan? 7 people. Look, I don't know if I'm pronouncing the countries properly because, you know, they have their peculiarity there. You know, some different names. But I'm not looking at the name. I'm looking at the souls there. Look how amazing. You who are sponsoring this work, you who are helping with the media work. Yes, you who are presenting your tithes and offerings. Can you see? We are rescuing people from all over the world, even places where we don't have church. Yes, I didn't mention now, but people from Iran as well, they're watching us. Look at the countries. Look at that. And may God prosper all of you abundantly. May God bless all of you ravens abundantly. You ravens who are supporting this work, you who are helping with the needs of God's work, you can be sure God is going to manifest His power greatly in your lives. He's not going to let you lack anything. And let's continue working together. Let's continue rescuing souls together from everywhere in the world. And we are receiving testimonies from everywhere as well. And we're going to be playing them here, no matter where they are from. As I said before, even if it comes on a language that nobody here understands, but somebody will understand, and they're going to translate into English for us. But I'm sure here in the UK we have quite a few people who have testimonies. Come on, let's go. Universal Church, United Kingdom. Where is the UCKG? UK. Huh? Let's use our faith. And don't forget, prepare your water. In a few moments, we're going to be determining your healing and the healing of your family members. Let's watch one more. Yes. And this one, he joined us. He joined our program, Be Inspired. He used his faith because he wanted his family members to be healed. And you're going to see how great. Through the water, he believed and God honored his faith. Let's watch together.
Hello, my name is Bradley from Edmonton, and I have a testimony in regards of my family. So last week I left to go to university, and a few days later I found out that my family was ill, that my brothers were ill, my little brother was vomiting and stuff like that. So then I remember being inspired on Tuesday at 10 p.m. is usually to do with regards of healing. So I decided to tune into that. And then I remember the bishop saying that by his stripes that we are healed, by the stripes of Jesus. So I just used my faith and I determined that as I drink this bottle, my family will be healed. So as I drank it, I determined it. And then I messaged my little brother saying like, how is the family? And does anybody feel sick? And then he messaged me that none of my brothers were sick anymore. So I just like to give all the glory and the honor to God.
This is it. That's the spirit. That's the faith, Bradley. He believed. He joined us. He consecrated the water like we're going to do in a few moments. He drank it on behalf of his family members. And look how great. They were healed. This is it. The same can happen to you and to your house. Do you have a family member who is sick? Do you have someone who needs healing in your house? Maybe this person is not connected. Let's use our faith on her behalf. This is it. And if you are in pain, you who are sick, you who are there feeling depressed, maybe now because of this lockdown, because of all these situations happening around, you are feeling sad, anguished, let's use our faith together. God is going to help you to overcome whatever it is there. There is nothing too hard for Him, as we keep saying to you. It's not us. The Word of God mentions that. Is anything too hard for our God? Not at all. And look at the teaching of Jesus. This one we're going to practice now. Are you ready? Where is your water, by the way? Is your water there? Prepare yourself. God bless you all from Edmonton as well. Bradley, continue using your faith if you are there. Let's continue using our faith, and may God bless you all from Edmonton. And more testimonies will come. They are going to happen now. Prepare yourself, because you will be the next testimony. Open your Bibles quickly, very quickly there, please. In the book of Mark, the Gospel of Mark, chapter 11. What a teaching, what a lesson. And it's for those who believe, I'm telling you. Those who don't believe, they're going to laugh. Those who don't believe, they're going to start typing nonsense there. Again, ignore the nonsense and focus on what makes sense. All right? The Word of God is what matters, what makes sense. Mark 11, chapter 11. I'm going to go straight here to verse 22. It's the lesson of the withered fig tree. Powerful. Afterwards, you can read the whole chapter. So many amazing lessons here. But this one here, look at this. Verse 22, Mark 11, 22. So Jesus answered and said to them, look at this, Jesus spoke. You who have the Bishop's Bible there, it's written in red, like my Bible here, right? Let's read together. Look at this. Jesus answered and said to them, have faith in God. Look how strong. Put your faith in God. Don't put your faith on people, traditions, religions. Look at this. Have faith in God. Continuing there. For assuredly, I say to you. Look how he starts. He doesn't say, I say to you. He says, assuredly. Look at this. He's assuring us for sure. I say to you, whoever, anybody, says to this mountain, maybe there was a mountain there nearby, and he said, be removed and be cast into the sea. Look at this, something impossible, right? Focus on this impossible act. Imagine something impossible Jesus is mentioning here. But as we know, with God, all things are possible. Be removed and be cast into the sea. Now, there comes the crucial part. Look at this. And does not doubt in his heart, but believes that those things he says. Focus on this here. He says, look at this, speaking, whatever he says. So does not doubt in his heart, but believes that those things he says will be done, he will have, my goodness, whatever. He will have whatever he says. Look how powerful. Therefore, Jesus concludes there. What a lesson. I say to you, can you see he's speaking to you, he's speaking to us now. Whatever things you ask when you pray, believe that you receive them and you will have them. I'm going to close the Bible. I'm going to stop here. This is powerful. Listen, run quickly there if you didn't get the water. You who have yours, we're going to practice this right now. Come on. We are going to use our faith. We are going to command this sickness in your body. This is it. Prepare yourself because you're going to speak to this cancer. You're going to speak to the viruses. You're going to speak to tumors. You're going to speak to the pain. You are going to speak to this problem, this mountain there. You are going to command it to depart from your life. You are going to speak, say in Jesus' name, get out of my body. You are going to say, get out of my family member's body. And as you believe, if you don't doubt, whatever you say will happen. Look how powerful. This is not my direction. If there is anyone there saying, why are you saying this? Why are you teaching people this? This is Jesus' teaching. Jesus is teaching whoever believes. And you who have just connected, maybe this is your first time, you were there in pain, in agony. Somehow God made this link reach you out. It arrived there, maybe in your phone or computer, email. I don't know how this link arrived there. I don't know how this post arrived there. One thing I know, if you are there, God wants to set you free. God wants to deliver you. He has seen your suffering. He saw your agony. He sees that there is a problem in your family and you are there saying, what else do I do? What else can I do? Get your water. Go quickly there. We're going to go for a quick break just for you to prepare your water there. When we come back, I'm going to be even there closer to you because we are going to command these problems in your health, in your family to depart. And whoever believes, listen, it will be done for them according to their faith. Run quickly there.
I am weary from the waves, crashing over every day. God of mercy, please come rescue me. I am longing for your voice, gentle whisper in the noise. Father, tell me everything's alright. Your power and your presence break strongholds, King of heaven. When you speak, mountains move. I believe there will be breakthrough. You alone can take my scars, piece by piece, restore my heart. Take what's broken, make it whole again. In your power and your presence, break strongholds, King of heaven. When you speak, mountains move. I believe there will be breakthrough. Oh, there will be breakthrough.
Be inspired on Liberty Radio.
Let's use our faith. Come on. Shake off the dust. Whoever is there right now, I don't see you. And I don't need to see you now because I know one thing. Soon, I'm going to play your testimony here. I don't know whose testimony is going to be played here. Whoever believes now, whoever decides now, you see, it's a decision to use his faith with me. God is going to honor your faith right now. Can you stand up where you are? Only if you can. I know that some of you are in bed. I know some of you right now, you are there even barely opening your eyes. Maybe you are sick. You are there struggling. We're going to use our faith. We're going to command this sickness to depart. The root cause of this problem, whatever it is, to leave. Evil spirits, spirits of infirmity, you name it. Whatever physical problem that you might be facing there or experiencing, suffering with, let's determine that it will depart. Jesus was the one who taught us, if you believe, have faith in God, remember, if you say to this mountain to move and you don't doubt, whatever you say will happen. And remember, when we pray, believe that what you are asking for will be yours. And it's going to be yours. Let's use our faith now. We're going to do this right now. Listen carefully. Put your water there next to you. My water is here. First, we are going to give an order to this pain. We're going to give an order to this sickness that is there in your body. You're going to even place your hands there. Place your hands on your head. And don't worry about people who laugh. Stop looking at them, please. Don't distract yourselves. Maybe something is happening there next to you. Look, it's to distract you. Maybe there is a noise there or somebody has just appeared there. Don't distract yourself. Hey, look at me here. Look at me here because you are going to experience God's power. When I ask you to place your hands where you have the pain, the sickness, even if you have a family member who is sick, what you do? Place your hands where this person has a problem. Place your hands there on your legs, on your head, shoulder. I don't know. If you cannot reach out, the area there, place your hands on the top of your head. But let's use our faith. No music now, nothing now, because I want to speak against this problem. Yes, and I'm going to do it for you now, with you actually. Yes, correcting here, with you. Come on, believe. Have faith in God. Come on, have faith in God. You need to be with me. Let's go. If you have been crying, if you have been complaining, if you are there saying, oh my God, why is this happening? Enough is enough. Let's go. Look at me here. God is with you. Something great is going to happen right now. Please, place your hands where you have the pain. Place your hands there, even on the top of your head, if you cannot touch the area of your body there where there is a problem. And do it for your family member. Yes, place your hands there. Close your eyes now, please. Lord Jesus, I believe. That's why I'm here. You said that if we have faith as small as a mustard seed, we can speak to a mountain. Yes, we can say to a mountain to move. And if we don't doubt, it will happen. Ah, my Lord, I know that you gave this example to show people that even what for us seems impossible, by faith, nothing is impossible. So now, my Lord, we stretch out our hands towards these people. Those who are placing their hands on their bodies, where there is a pain, there is a sickness. Ah, my Lord, as they cast out this problem, as they speak against this problem and take off their hands off their bodies and say, get out, we determine this problem will get out. In Jesus' name, with your eyes closed, say with me now, pain, diseases in my body, in my life, in my family, say, I rebuke you. I command you. In Jesus' name, take your hands off your body and say, get out. Yes, get out, diseases. Leave their bodies now. Depression, oppression, infirmities, depart from their lives. Leave their families now and never come back again. In Jesus' name. Now, hold the water in your hands. Hold it there, like this. Close your eyes, please. Father, in the name of Jesus, I know something is happening there. And Lord, I determine, as they drink this water, may this water be the holy medication that will now bring an end to whatever problem that might be affecting them and their families. Consecrate this water, my Lord. I believe, they believe, so honor our faith. I determine now it's blessed. And I thank you, Lord. Thank you because I know the new testimonies are on their way. And tonight we're going to have testimonies like never before. Thank you, my Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Drink this water in faith and receive healing deliverance. Just believe. Yes, receive your healing. Say there now, I'm healed in Jesus' name. And now, move your body. Do it. Do it. I'm sure you can do it. Go ahead. Yes, stretch out your arms. Move your hand like this. Bend. Look. Bend over. Now you can. You can because you are healed. Jesus sets you free right now. Yes, it's real. Be free from depression. Be free from the oppression, the sadness. Take a deep breath there now. Look. Do like this. And be free. Receive life. Even breathing better, you can now. Yes, Jesus is bringing healing to you. All of you who are there, the family members whose names are written there on the chat, they are healed right now. Yes, you and your family members, be healed in Jesus' name. Let's go for a quick break. I know something's happening there. I know some of you are typing there, but type there what has happened. You who don't feel the pain, you who no longer have that heaviness, you are no longer depressed, great. So share here. Type here your testimony. Few lines, few words, I mean. And let's glorify God together. We'll be right back.
At that time, I actually was having problems concerning my heart. Whenever I walked, I was having so much problems. I went to my GP, who referred me to Newham Hospital, to the heart specialist. They checked my heart, and I was sent for a scan, which revealed that I had a problem on the left
side of my artery, there was a big bulge. I was later sent to St. Paul's Hospital. But in between this time, the day of power came, I received the oil, and I started to anoint myself. I determined that I would not accept this situation, because the things that I was told would happen is that I would be prone to heart attacks, prone to problems with my heart, prone to having strokes and other problems that were not reflecting to the age that I was. I used my faith every single day. I anointed myself, I prayed, and I gave glory to God for my healing, even though I didn't get my results. When I got my results, it was through a phone call through my nurse, and she said to me, "Mercy, you need to celebrate because you are free. We can't find anything concerning the problem in your bulge that was on your artery has completely disappeared. No evidence of the bulge, no problem with your heart, no problem whatsoever." And what I noticed within those 2 weeks is I started breathing properly. I would walk. I wouldn't even start like having pain. I could breathe normally. I wasn't having any problem whatsoever. So my healing actually took place in between those 2 weeks from the results and the time that I also used my faith. So I give glory to God for everything that He's done for me. Till now, I've not had no problems whatsoever, no reoccurrence of the problem, and I give glory to God. Use the oil in faith and God will honor you. Thank you.
On Sunday, 31st January, a free distribution of the holy oil will occur at 10 a.m. at 232 Seven Sisters Road, Finsbury Park, London N4 3NX, or at any Universal Church near you. This will be the only distribution this year.
Be inspired on Liberty Radio.
Look how great. New testimonies are on their way. All of you who saw results there, you who are experiencing a change there, and many of you will experience tomorrow as you continue believing, don't forget, record your testimony. I know many of you are saying there, "My family is healed, something happened in my body." Yes, you are seeing results, but record your testimony. Yes, like you saw there, Mercy giving her testimony about the holy oil. Look how great. And with this event, prepare yourselves. Greater testimonies will be played here. So you who have your testimony, you who saw results now, don't leave it for tomorrow. Even tonight, record it, send it to us. If you cannot tonight, so tomorrow. Come on, send it to this email address. Have a look there. mytestimony@uckg.org. Or you can send it via WhatsApp. 020-7686-6000. Be part of the great cloud. The cloud is getting bigger and bigger. And tonight, we are making it happen. This is it. New testimonies are on their way. And especially with this event that will happen in all of our churches all over the UK, all over the world, by the way. We're going to be anointing the sick. We're going to be also anointing family members. We're going to be praying for God, not only to heal, deliver people, but also to bless, to protect those who will be joining us. It's going to be very, very strong. So don't forget, 31st of January, the last Sunday of this month, as you can see there, the Holy Oil event. We're going to be distributing the oil that was blessed at Solomon's Temple. You can see Bishop Macedo there holding the bottle. We have just received this oil. Look at the bishops there praying at the altar of the Temple of Solomon. They consecrated the oil, and they determined there that wherever this oil arrives, healing, deliverance will arrive. The power of God will be manifested. So 31st of December, especially at 10 a.m., don't forget to invite your friends, family members. And as you saw there, it's going to be the only distribution of the year, this month of January. Some people were asking us, "What about myself? I'm self-isolating. What about me?" Give us a call. We're going to give instructions. You're not going to be left out. Don't worry. Don't worry. We are here to care for you. Do you think we're going to leave you outside of the great cloud? Huh? You are going to be blessed as well. It's not your fault. I understand. Some of you, if you could, you would be here. If you can, you know, join us. It's understandable you can, but and those who cannot, those who are self-isolating. So give us a call. That's our number, 020-7686-6000. So you may receive instructions, okay? Just let them know. Say, look, I am self-isolating. What do I do? They're going to give you some directions. You can send us a message as well via WhatsApp, 020-7686-6000, the same number, okay? And let us know who is coming. We gave you a leaflet for you to write down the names of your guests. We need to know how many people will be coming to our branches. So every branch is ready to receive safely whoever will be joining us on the 31st, especially at 10 a.m. We're going to be doing this throughout the day on Sunday, but especially 10 a.m., especially here in Finsbury Park. That's our address, 2327 Sisters Road, N43NX. We are in Finsbury Park. That's London, United Kingdom. But we also have churches everywhere in the UK. That's our website, uckg.org/addresses. All the addresses are there. Even you who are watching us from abroad, you can find out which address is near you. If you are in Asia, Oceania, South, North America, Africa, all over Europe, we have churches in more than 130 countries. And soon, we're going to have churches in more countries. And you who are watching us from a place where there is no church, you're wondering there, hey, now what about me? Send us a message. Yes, you can give us a call. We are here to give you directions, okay? We will clarify your doubts, answer your questions. Just, again, give us a call or send us a message via WhatsApp. 020-7686-6000. I'm going to let you go now. And don't forget, I'll be back here tomorrow at 10 p.m. again. But in church, we're going to have our Bible study. And it's been very, very strong. We are talking about deliverance, but not from evil spirits, but from the flesh, the works of the flesh. So you who want to have established relationship with God, you who want to overcome certain things that are dominating you, join us tomorrow. If you are self-isolating, we're going to be transmitting via Liberty Radio as well, our evening service, 7:30 p.m. But if you can make it to one of our branches, don't forget to bring your Bible and let's continue using our faith together. Let's continue learning with the Word of God how we can overcome now our flesh, the works of the flesh. You who want the Holy Spirit, look, we're going to be seeking the Holy Spirit tomorrow in church and here on the radio. And don't forget, continue focusing on the baptism in the Holy Spirit. That's your priority. Don't forget it. The Holy Spirit, the baptism in the Holy Spirit is a must for those who have not yet been baptized. So I'm going to be in Finsbury Park, as you saw there, but you can go to any UCKG across the UK, across the globe, okay? So I'm going to let you go now. Let's continue using our faith here every night at 10 p.m. UK time. And in case you are watching us now from Facebook, so we are repeating this program on Facebook. God bless you all. Don't forget always to repost everything that is placed on the social network. Let's make sure that more people receive the blessings that we are receiving. God bless you. Have a wonderful day, afternoon, evening. We see you here or in church. Bye-bye.
I am weary from the waves, crashing over every day. God of mercy, please come rescue me. I am longing for your voice, gentle whisper in the noise. Father, tell me everything's all right. Your power believe there will be breakthrough. You alone can take my scars, piece by piece, restore my heart. Take what's broken, make it whole again. In your power, in your presence, break strongholds, King of heaven. When you speak, mountains move. I believe there will be breakthrough. Oh, there will be breakthrough. Shake the mountains, break the walls apart, open the heavens, Almighty God you are. Overcomer, defender of my heart. And by your power, the oceans open wide. Your fire falls down, heaven and earth collide. King Jesus, forever by my side. Your power and your presence break strongholds, King of heaven. When you speak, mountains move. I believe there will be breakthrough. Your power and your presence break strongholds, King of heaven. When you speak, mountains move. I believe there will be breakthrough. There will be breakthrough.
Due to ongoing concerns with COVID-19, we would like to reassure our members and visitors that all UCKG venues remain a safe place to attend for private prayers and services. Communal areas are regularly cleaned and individual single-use materials are provided in place of shared materials. Social distancing procedures continue to be in operation at all our venues to ensure your safety and protection, as well as that of others. We operate a meticulous cleaning schedule during and in between services. You can be confident that though these are unprecedented times, the UCKG remains a safe place for you and your family at all times. Join us today at your nearest venue. Find out more by going to uckg.org/addresses or by calling 020-7686-6000.
Radio.
If you would like to donate in support of this work, please do so by any of the following ways: via online banking using our details as provided, through the QR code which will take you to the payment page on our website, or via Pingit with the details provided. Thank you for your help.